going to testify. Give her a good warm welcome.
Hallelujah.
I don't know about you, but that was powerful. Many of you have known me for several years. Some of you have heard my background, but most of you haven't. So I'll try not to take sermon time. One of the things that's said in that song is, I am your future, so leave your past behind. But I need to remember what was in my past, because God's work was miracle. I'm going to go through some things that have happened, but I'm not a victim. God has worked a lot of things out in my life. One of the things that occurred most of my childhood was sexual abuse. I don't remember when it started. My earliest memory is about age 3. And I know it went for about junior high. In my family, there is generational sin. On one side of my family, I've talked to a grandmother, an aunt, and I know it's gone back at least 5 generations. I want it to end with me. That's been my prayer, is let it end with this generation. Don't let it go any further. And God has taken a lot of chains and broken them. It's taken a lot of work. But I'm not that little girl anymore. And I have a lot of power. And God has given me that power. Through that, I did choose a husband the first time around that was into pornography that I didn't know about. And I don't know if y'all realize that most of the time, cycles tend to happen. If you haven't gotten healed, then you tend to repeat it. And I hadn't gotten healing at that point. I was like, I'm good, everything's fine with me, you know. I'm happy, I just go along my day. Well, eventually, when I was in my 20s, I realized I'm not so okay. And I had to start doing some hard work. But in the meantime, I'd gotten married. And we were married for about 7 years. And it wasn't a healthy marriage. And eventually, it did end in divorce. And within a month of me moving out, he had moved his girlfriend and her 2 kids. That he met on the internet. And this is more common than y'all realize. It's very, very common. And homes are being broken apart because of technology today and how easily it is accessed. But God worked through me during that situation. My marriage was difficult, but he wasn't the only contributor to that marriage. It takes 2. And it wasn't until after we were divorced, and I had gone, separated myself from, you know, no phone calls, no emails, no anything finally, and moved to a whole other town. And I started realizing, once the anger started going away, I started realizing, you know what? There was a lot of stuff that I contributed to the demise of that marriage also. And so I had to go through a lot of work and healing in myself to realize, you know, I can't just be finger pointing. And, you know, I've got to realize my own mistakes so that I don't do it again. And so I went through a lot of healing during that time. And at the same time that I separated from my husband at the time, the doors of my church also shut. So I felt like I was lost, completely abandoned. I didn't know where to turn. Major depression hit. It affected my job. They made me take leave for a whole month and go get some help. It was severe depression. God worked through that. He opened, I ended up with a lot of debt in the divorce because I knew he wouldn't pay it, the attorney said, you know, if he doesn't pay, it's going to come back to me anyway, the interest of it, we'll just give it to me. And so I took all the debt, and God provided a job for me to be able to change jobs, that I was able to pay off all of that debt in 1 year.
Amen.
You know, he gave me the ability to say, you don't need to buy that. You don't need to do this. I don't know if you've heard of the envelope system where you do cash only. Well, it works. So it's so easy to slide that little card. And in 1 year, God allowed me to get debt free. So a lot of that burden, a lot of that baggage was let loose. And if you've ever been debt-free, oh my goodness, the freedom you feel is absolutely amazing. It's absolutely amazing. I'd gotten that new job, and then God was saying, maybe it's time to move on. And so my family lives down south in Houston, and then I had a brother who lives here. And I thought, well, I really don't want to move back down to where all the family. I love my family, but there's a lot of stuff down there I don't need to move back to. So I decided to move here. So I came here, I had two job interviews, and then I found a place to go and look for a place to live. So it was going to be a quick trip here. Well, during that time, I got offered both jobs in the same day, the day I interviewed. And I found a place to live that same day. So, and I knew it was God. Because he's the only one who can work it out that says, this is it. He says, move, okay? I've been looking about moving before that, but this was like, move. And so I finally came, I interviewed, I got the job, I turned in my resignation that next day, and 2 weeks later, I moved to Longview.
Amen.
And he had his hands in it. He had me in a wonderful job that I loved. I am a clinical social worker, and so I did counseling for groups, families, and individuals. Well, God provided me through my education and through that for my own healing.
Amen.
I haven't had to work for about 6 years now, and if I never work again, I kept my license up, but if I never work again, that degree did not go to waste.
Amen.
Because God provided people in my life through that entire situation, through every job I've been in, that has helped me progress in my healing.
Amen.
And God uses people.
Amen.
You know, for some, it's instantaneous healing, and the clouds are gone, and the chains are broken instantaneously. Well, that wasn't me. Okay? God used people along the way, and it's been a journey, it's been a process. And I'm so thankful for the people that he's put in my life to help with that healing. I'm thankful that he gave me godly parents that raised me in church. Because I've known forever that God was the one I could call to. You know, I can remember as a child in my bed holding my teddy bear, saying, crying, saying, God help me. You know, why? God's been there the entire time. He hasn't left me. Even through my depression, even through my rebellion, because after my divorce, I think there were a lot of rebellions out there. You, God, I dare you. You lead me too. And I made a lot of mistakes, did a lot of things that I regret, but I don't condemn myself about them anymore. And I did that for a long time. But again, that's God's healing. Well, about 6 months after I moved here, one of my coworkers got me into a training in leadership training in Dallas. Where I met Trey Smith. So Trey is my coworker's sister, and so she got both of us there. We didn't know we were going; we'd never met before. So we met in Dallas, realized that we were from the same town, so we started traveling back. And during this leadership training, there was one thing that really made a huge impact on me. And we did a you know, all of those kinds of things. And what's my purpose? Why am I even here? Well, you're in a lifeboat, and there were 32 of us in the group. And, okay, you're on a ship. The ship is going down. There's a lifeboat, and only one person can get in the lifeboat. So we all had to say why we thought we deserved to be in the lifeboat. Well, then you got in a circle, and you were given three popsicle sticks. And you went around, and you had to pick three people that you thought was worthy, that you thought would benefit from being in that lifeboat. And you gave them, out. And then, at the end, they figured out who had the most popsicle sticks. I was given the most popsicle sticks. It showed me I'm making an impact on people. I didn't realize it. I didn't realize that just by being me, I made an impact on the very people around me. And God has used that to build my confidence and allow me to have relationships and to go forward in my life in ways that I wouldn't have been able to before. There were so many exercises in there, but that was the one that made the most impact for me. Well, Trey wanted it to do ballroom dance lessons, so he needed a partner. So he asked me, "Tammy, would you like to do ballroom dance? We're just friends." And so I said, "Sure." He's paying for it, so why not? You know, I'm from a Baptist. We don't dance. So let's do some ballroom dancing. So for almost 2 years, we were ballroom dance partners. We basically went to lesson once a week, went out to eat afterwards, and then occasionally, every couple of months, there was dance, and so we'd go to the dance. Well, after almost 2 years, things started changing. All of a sudden, he started holding my hand when I was leaving the dance floor. And I thought, what's happening? Times changing. And within a few months, we were married. We had to get past the age thing because we're 25 years apart, and so I had to do some recognizing, and God had to do some. It's okay with me, age, you know, to God, age doesn't matter.
Amen.
Trey had to do the same thing since I was oldest as children, and so I'm very blessed to be in that family because his children love me, they accept me. And I couldn't ask for a better family to be a part of. So, through my first marriage, I learned a lot that is now helping me with my second marriage. There are a lot of things I've done different. I strive very hard to show my husband respect all the time. Even in my mind. Because that's where it starts. It's not the big stuff that tends to break up marriages. It's the little stuff. And Trey and I have a fantastic marriage that we actually communicate and talk. Imagine that, actually having a relationship. And so, our marriage, we've been married almost 7 years, almost as long as I've been married in my first marriage. And it just seems like it's flown by. Like, we haven't even been married that long. It's been a beautiful, beautiful marriage. Well, most of you know that a few years ago, I was told I couldn't have any children. We did go through the testing and all that, and they said, "Tammy, with your age and everything, it's not going to happen. There's medical things going on, it's just not going to happen." And they said, even if you did in vitro, it'll only be 20% chance. And if you did have a baby, there is a higher likelihood of having a baby with Down syndrome or another genetic disorder. We had already decided if we weren't going to take extreme measures, that if it wasn't meant to be, then God had another purpose. Well, again, I doubted God. I was angry. I was hurt. I thought, okay, God, why did you give me this desire only to say it can't happen? So almost a year and a half, almost 2 years, after I found out, Trey's youngest daughter was having a baby. our granddaughter, and I held her for the first time last year in October. That's the first baby I held in 2 years. Within 2 weeks, I was pregnant. The feeling of fear, because I thought, God, you already said no. Now I've already figured out I'm going to do something different in life. It's a good idea not to have a baby. Now you've got to change my mind again. So then I had to rewire my brain to say, this is a good thing. So we have beautiful Adeline, poor thing. She was crying back there in the nursery, but her daddy's got her now, and she's just resting on his shoulder. And she's my miracle baby. She's my miracle. And even now, those of you moms, six of me moms, all of that, all those fears of what if this happens? What if she stops breathing? What if this? I'm like, God, I give her to you. I trust you with her. Because you proved over and over and over and over again that you're going to take care of me, that you're going to be there, that I can rely on you, I can trust you, okay? For someone, I've had trust issues my whole life, with good reason. I still struggle with that at times. Ask Trey about my control issues. But God has worked things out. He's created times of trial. He's created allowed times of celebration. Our faith doesn't go on an even plane. Our relationship with God isn't always level. We have our ups and we have our downs. We have our mountains and we have our valleys. And God is there every step of the way as we go through. So, with that said, I just want to say, I'm free. Yeah, we all have our issues. I still have issues. Okay, I'm human. I'm still on a journey. I'm still a work in progress. God's holding my hand every step of the way. But I hope that my faith and my trust in Him has grown as I've gone through each of these steps, as He's walked with me, that I realize, He didn't leave me behind. He didn't forget about me. He's been here every step of the way.
Give the Lord your praise.